The NFL, NBA, NHL, and European soccer are just the tip of the iceberg with Jay Croucher and Drew Dinsick on Bet the Edge. Join the guys every weekday at 6 a.m. Eastern on our NBC Sports YouTube page or wherever you listen to your podcast. Oh, yeah, they have horse racing cover, too, and we'll get to that in just a second. The Dollarita is here for a limited time, only at Applebee's. It's a margarita for just $1. Don't overthink this, everyone. The Dollarita is a delicious and safe choice for your wallet. So which horses do you think are good bets to pay from that wallet? Drew Dinsick, welcome to the show. Second year in a row.
Absolutely. Second year in a row, Drew Dinsick.
So good. We're back for more.
Becoming part of the Fantasy Football Happy Hour cinematic universe here.
You're stop saying that.
And you really love that.
And I really
were you
do.
Ever in a movie?
I was once before.
You don't really talk about
Manchester
it.
By the Sea.
Yeah, but, and it's by the way, it's the 5-year anniversary of Avengers Endgame. Go watch it now. But what I want to tell you about is that there was a horse that Drew Dinsick and I loved. We were at the Super Bowl. All of us, but Jay was nowhere to be found. He was drowning in sorrows. I don't know if you remember, but he had a bunch of money on DeMar Hamlin, which he lost in the Rookie of the Year. Yeah. So anyway, Drew Dinsick and I, and we found this horse, and by we I mean Drew, found this horse, 100-1 odds, speakeasy, and so Drew was able to get 100-1 odds, and so I took 20% of his bet. We were going to be partners on this horse. And what happened, Drew?
He gets scratched. That happens in horse racing. Yeah. He was an incredible maiden run from him. He beat a heavy favorite in Gulfstream, Todd Pletcher trained horse, and not to be. But that's kind of a common theme. Like, they're really, really being very careful with the elite thoroughbreds now. There's a ton of, like, very conscientious effort to just, you know, positive outcomes for these horses. And that was kind of a theme of the Derby last year, as we had the favorite scratch. And what's interesting carry through to this year is that the favorite of this race, same owner, Repulse Stables, same trainer, Todd Pletcher, Fierceness, kind of stands above the rest of the field. And I would actually kind of look at it and say, outside of that one horse, this is somewhat of a weak field. And, you know, so you're seeing even professionals circle around the favorite in this race in Fierceness, who's going to be wearing number 17 on Saturday. And for good reason, because he's had just an outstanding, you know, preparation run up here. Basically a no contest in the Florida Derby, Breeders' Cup Juvenile Champion, and he's really quite a horse.
Drew, where's our confidence level in Fierceness? How many Dollaritas are we talking here if we had to pony up?
Okay, so right now, if you bet one Dollarita, you're only going to get three if he wins. And, you know, in most sports, if you're betting a 3-1 and you get it home, you're pretty stoked.
Yeah, you love that. Like
sure. You're pretty excited. But in horse racing, that's pretty short. There's going to be 20 horses out there. It's going to be a crowded field. And I think what I would choose to do with my Dollarita bet on this race is bet that Dollarita on Fierceness to finish first and then take some longer shots in the exacta to finish second, because the other quality horses, the next tier after Fierceness, they're all closers. And they can absolutely, if it is a fast pace to start in particular, they can clean up that field coming around the final turn, come down the home stretch. And so the horse that it really caught my eye here, caught my eye in the run-up, was Honor Marie. Right now, bet into that at 20-1 plus in the futures pool. So knocking on wood that Honor Marie gives us an honest race. And if it comes in Fierceness 1 over Honor Marie, that'll be like one Dollarita pays something like 50, which will be nice.
Okay.
That's a lot more Dollaritas.
Well, firstly, I need to draw attention to the fact that Drew Dinsick is not wearing makeup for this. This is just his natural appearance. It's magnificent, as opposed to three artificially constructed men next to him. But Drew, is there any horse that you want to fade in the race? Anyone that you think is way too shortly priced?
Yeah, so there's one that stands out, and it's the second choice, Sierra Leone. It's an amazing horse, Chad Brown trained, and really just has had a very, very solid run-up. The problem for me is that at 4-1, this horse is a closer. It's going to need things to go right in order to have a chance to win. And frankly, at 4-1, that's not a good enough price for a closer, on top of the fact that we have a problem where where Sierra Leone is going to have to make its way through a 20-horse field in order to get up closer to the front of the race. So Sierra Leone, I'm against. Fierceness, Honor Marie, I'm on.
Before we get out of here, Drew, any long shots that you're keeping your eye on?
I like Endlessly. Big price right there. Support for Endlessly, and that's another closer that has the potential to hit the board. And that's, you know, again, if you're going with you're trying to construct a big ticket, you need a bomb like that in the third or fourth hole, and Endlessly is going to be my shot.
I like that a lot. I'll just tell you this. He won't say it, but I will. Drew Dinsick made a lot of friends last year because he called Mage before the race went off.
No one
was expecting Mage. I went off at 15-1 last year.
Yeah, it was a big number. It was nice.
Thank you for that. So here it is.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So anyway, it didn't tell me. Didn't tell me. But
another
like
group text you were left out of.
Yes, that was another group text
that
I was left out of.
But you know, we don't have time for the story, but Drew actually made money for Dustin Pedroia and Jacoby Ellsbury at the Derby last year, but not for me. Matthew.
No,
that's
well,
all right.
They're
Jacoby
famous.
Ellsbury did well.
They're famous or not. Maybe if I could get into a social media picture, Jay, maybe Drew would recognize me more, and he'll give me picks this year. We'll see. Anyway, that music means it's closing time. Dollaritas for everyone. I'm heading to the bar.
Yes.
That's right.
You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Stick around for Bet the Edge. Jay Crouch, O'Connor, Roger, Drew Dinsick. I'm Matthew Berry. Peace out!
Hey, it's Matthew Berry from NBCSports.com and RotorWorld.com, and I want to thank you so much for watching whatever it is you just watched, or if nothing else, being too lazy to click out of the autoplay after this video started, after whatever it is you actually wanted to watch finished. But now that you're here, I'd like to take a moment here to ask you respectfully now, okay? I'm asking you respectfully to subscribe to the NFL on NBC YouTube channel. You'll get the latest RotoWorld fantasy news headlines, all sorts of great shows, including my own Fantasy Football Happy Hour. So go subscribe now. Again, I'm asking respectfully.